Grace, mercy, and peace to you from our living God and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Last evening, on Maundy Thursday, we heard Jesus give a new command. The command that we love one another as he first loved us. That by this, by loving one another, they would know that we are his disciples. And we talked about the fact that loving one another, though it sounds easy, can in fact be very, very difficult. Particularly if you're talking about loving someone who betrayed you, or abused you, or wished ill against you. That in fact, to love one another in the midst of the brokenness of this world can at times be the most difficult thing that we are ever called to do. And so don't ever think of Jesus' command that we love one another as a simple one, because it isn't. Tonight we are reminded to what lengths of love Jesus was willing to go. For you and for me and for all of us. For the whole world, in fact, we are reminded the lengths of that love. And certainly it was not easy. It was, in fact, very difficult, very painful. We have a way often of talking about Jesus that I think almost belittles his experience. We often say things like, Jesus died for our sins. And while that is true, Jesus didn't just die. He was crucified. He was executed. He was assassinated by the religious and political powers of his day. I find it interesting that many times today we even have a difficult time using the word died. We often hear that someone passed, or that someone passed over to the other side, or that someone transitioned, or that someone's life ended. Find it difficult as a society to use the word death or died. And yet what Jesus experienced this night was so much more. There is something in the scripture tonight which I firmly believe is designed to be metaphorically true, rather than historically true. And that is when John talks about the fact that Jesus died in a garden. That there was a garden in the place where he was crucified, and in the garden there was a new tomb in which no one had ever been laid. That most likely is meant to be a preemptive metaphor of the resurrection. But the fact of the matter would have been that Jesus was not crucified in a garden, but on Golgotha, outside the city walls, and it was most likely a garbage dump. Every city in the ancient world, outside the city walls, there would have been the place where people took their garbage. And it was in those garbage dumps that the Romans crucified people, not in a garden. It was in a garbage dump. This afternoon, some of our young people from St. Peter's and from the Episcopal Church of the Holy Spirit, we went and we collected garbage, trash from the beach, and we brought it back and we placed it on this cross. There's even to remind us of the depth of Jesus' love, of the place where he died, and of the garbage that Jesus took with him, the garbage of our own lives, he takes with him on the cross. Many of these symbols of our society are things that others would long for, would yearn for. In many third world countries around the world, people live literally on the garbage dumps. Those who are the most poor, and they live a life of scavenging what they can get, the little that they can find from the local garbage dump. When I was in El Salvador, almost every year I would go to visit a church that was called La Iglesia de Santa Maria, the Church of St. Mary. And it was located literally beside the garbage dump outside the capital city of San Salvador. And that's how the people existed. The children would walk barefoot through the garbage dump, up over huge heaping piles, and they would look through to find little bits of edible food or things that they might be able to still take to the marketplace and sell to make money for the family. And that was their total existence. And when I think of that image, of that little congregation, and I think of Jesus dying on a mountain of garbage, I am reminded that those are precisely the people that Jesus came to die for. The widows and the children, the poor and the oppressed, those who are most vulnerable and most in need. There is no greater symbol of the ministry of Jesus than the fact that he died on a garbage heap. I would like to suggest that the rest of us get a free ride. We get a free ride because Jesus died for the poorest of the poor. But yet, he also dies for you and me. That Jesus died for those who were most in need, and yet most of us who are not in particular need, we get the free ride that goes along with Jesus' concern for those who are most in need. Now, am I suggesting that Jesus loves you and I any less than any of the others? Of course not. But I am suggesting that Jesus had a particular purpose in his life and ministry, and it was to bring liberation to God's people, and particularly to those who were in prison, to the blind, to the poor, to the captive, to the leper, to those who experienced the most brokenness in life. We all experience life's brokenness. This garbage is my garbage, and this garbage is your garbage. And tonight we simply gather together to remember and to retell this story in maybe a new way, that the garbage of our lives, Jesus is able to transform into the promise of hope and eternal life for all of God's children, and especially for those who are most in need. And that then the final task for us as people of God and as followers of Jesus is to fulfill the command that that he offered to us last night, to love one another as I have first loved you, because by loving one another, they will know that truly you are my disciples. As Jesus stands, hangs from the cross, he looks at his beloved disciple. Some people argue that was John. Others say it is symbolic of any person who follows Jesus. I prefer to think the latter. And so Jesus looks at you, his beloved disciple. He places his most precious possession into your hands, Mary, his mother. And he says, "Woman, this now is your son. Son, this is your woman, your mother." And as they come together, we are told, into a new household, so too, through the life, death, and resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, you and I become part of a new household as well. The household of all God's beloved, from a garbage dump to an empty tomb. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Most gracious God, we come to you this night thanking you for the witness of all your children. We come to you this night remembering that Jesus didn't just die on a cross in a garden, but that he was crucified on a garbage dump. We recognize the inhumanity that continues to exist throughout the world of our brothers and sisters who, for no fault of their own, are left and born into conditions of extreme poverty. And we are called to remember each and every day with all of our gifts and talents and opportunities to share your love with one another through Christ our Lord, in whose name we pray. Amen. Amen.